Hello, through this video we will show you how to design new power line using software PowerPath. As you can see, here we have some points with XYZ coordinates. And according to them, we will create our surface. We also have raster image. You can use your input data to create surface, or you can use our input data examples for creating surface. If you go here on help portal, you will find here surface data examples, and you will find here examples for creating surface according to input data. So you have just have to download them. I will go back and I will create my surface. You need to select your points and choose create surface from points polylines. Now, as you can see, our surface is created. You can select your surface, and if you want, you can turn off these triangles. Okay, we will go in top view and we will draw our power line. You can set the name of your power line. You can set your station, you can set the name of supports. For example, I will set this name. You can set your tension support model, and you can set your weather and reference conditions. Of course, you can drip your power line on existing surface. Now you just have to draw your power line. Okay, you can edit your power line just clicking on tension supports and moving whenever you want to put them on surface. You can add supports. If you click on this icon, you can add suspension or tension support. If you choose suspension support, you can choose which model you want to add. Okay, I will add some supports. And of course, you can add your tension supports. Okay, if you go in 3D view, you will see your power line. You can of course remove your supports. You can remove either tension or suspension. For example, you can remove the suspension support, and you can remove your tension support. If you remove your tension support, all suspension supports in that tension sections near that tension support will be removed. Okay, now I will add insulators. You have to use this icon to add your insulators and add insulator on any attachment point. You can choose what type you want to add and what model you want to add. And you can apply it to all supports of the same data model for that attachment point. So we choose tension support, and as you can see, we add our insulators on that attachment point on all tension supports. There is a quicker way to add our insulators. If you use this icon called edit insulator, you can add insulators on all attachment points for tension or suspension supports. For example, we have chosen tension support and we will add our insulators on tension support. And we will choose to apply it to all supports of the same data model. As you can see, our tension supports have insulators. Now, we will add insulators on our suspension supports. you can also apply to all supports of the same data model and just click OK. And as you can see, all our suspension supports have insulators. Now we will add conductors. You just have to go here on this icon called Add Conductor and choose your power line. You can set the name of your conductor, the model, then you can set from which to which support you want to add your conductor and on which attachment point, and you can edit and set your weather and reference conditions. Of course, you can add ground wire. You have to choose your power line and you can add your ground wire. You can set your name for ground wire. Then you can set your model. You can set from which to switch support you want your ground wire. And you can set weather and reference conditions for ground wire. And as you can see, here we have our power line in 3D view. And of course, we also have our power line in 2D view.